Hello, EPC family. Today I'd like to introduce the first in a series of occasional videos called 2-Minute Topics. These videos will address frequently asked questions posed to the Office of the Stated Clerk. Our topic today is the ordination process and specifically something called CEEP. CEEP stands for the Candidates Educational Equivalency Program, CEEP. And it is a way for non-traditional candidates for ministry to satisfy the educational requirements for ordination. As our flow chart shows, the traditional path for ordination is for a candidate to attend seminary, receive a Master of Divinity degree, and then sit for the ordination exams. Over time, however, the MDiv took on different shapes at different seminaries. In order to maintain a common standard throughout the EPC, the General Assembly created a list of required courses that every candidate must pass in their MDiv program. The question then came up, can a person satisfy those requirements without having a Master of Divinity? The General Assembly answered yes and created the CEEP. It's a program in which someone with an educational equivalent of an MDiv can sit for the ordination exams and become an EPC teaching elder. The process goes like this. A candidate with advanced training and experience compares their completed coursework with the EPC requirements for an MDiv. With their home presbytery's approval, the Permanent Ministerial Vocation Committee evaluates the candidate's coursework, compares it to the educational requirements, and recommends what courses, if any, need to be completed in order to have the equivalent of an MDiv. The Ministerial Vocation Committee makes these recommendations to the presbytery. When the presbytery determines the requirements have been met, the candidate can sit for the ordination exams. Also, it's important to note that the presbyteries and the Ministerial Vocation Committee have access to a number of programs and independent studies to help candidates meet the requirements in a timely and cost-effective way. Upon successful completion of the ordination examinations, the CEEP candidate could then receive a call and be ordained as an EPC teaching elder. I hope this information has been helpful to you. If you have any questions, feel free to email me. God bless you as you continue to serve the Lord in church leadership.